read a few more from the Kugel book, and then I'll read some new work. Let's see. I'll read a poem called Verbena. Verbena said no, meet me at Meg's, but the distance was great. We had to fly in order to see each other. I'm standing on a pontoon. Sue was making an abstract, wrapping a wire around a cardboard tube. Another person was disambiguated by Felicity. Meg had a disturbing way of eating, something about tasting life for the first time and then getting bored. It's a beautiful day for nothing to happen, to pour into our mugs, to open our mineral hearts. Absolute clarity makes it a dutiful way to the surface, blood. This is the standard way of explaining loss. If I was, you were, they better be. It's freezing on the platform, waiting for the pipes to clank. Will they? Something's afoot, we are afoot. So, I'm gonna read two more from this book. The next poem I'm gonna read is called Cliff Notes. And basically, when I was in my my 20s, early 30s, I kept a lot of journals. I still keep a lot of journals, but let's say I have like 30 journals from the age of 16 to now. And some of those journals in my 20s and 30s were devoted to like things like recording events, experiences, like how many, you know, women that I would hook up with or drugs that I would take. But then afterwards, I would read it over, like a long time over, and I was like, this is really not that interesting to read, you know? So I thought it would be interesting to abbreviate an abbreviated form of an experience from a journal. Cliff note, the fruitless fly never mates or settles down. It buzzes aimlessly, then dies. The fruit basket appears, ready to spill its contents at my feet. Japanese tourists visit Washington, D.C. every spring for the cherry blossoms, much to our chagrin. Once at Bump, I met Don Bridges. That encounter was drawn out, but better left unreported. The reason I liked her may stem from an unresolved issue regarding a trolley, 1 foot wedged in the tracks to be stung furiously at night. And, one more from this book. This is a poem called Sadness. So I took the first line from a painter named Agnes Martin. Okay, so I tried just existing, didn't much like it. Sadness wasn't sad, but pungent, a la Faustina. By and large, okay. Susie Prevett lived on the corner of turmeric and ginger root. I visited her house last April, didn't know her well. Books of Austin, Byron, Brown, and Poe's on decorum might as well boil it down to time signatures. The object thus made common, where does it come from? Mustn't be afraid of the clocks, they are our time, space, surface of an egg. My eyes in a mirror, something no one touches. Water running, lips wrapped around a spigot. All right, so I'll read a sequence. Sometimes I write in sequences. So I'm going to read one called 8.5. So 8.5 poems. Also modeled after the way Fellini's 8.5, the movie. One. In the white sterility of the frozen food empire, I lost my mind. What remained was sold to a grocery outfit. White bear of the poles, white shark of the tropics, instances of freezing, the dank foreboding of our wine cellar, only much bigger, like a floating metaphysical winter of snow and salt. Two, I first saw you. You had on blue jeans and a pair of kangaroos. You were at the blacklight party, standing next to a baked Alaska, made to look like an alien overmorph. In the future, they will know us from our weather-altered faces and floating Walmarts. Recently you bought an expensive dog, a French Griffon, and an armoire like all armoires, stuffed with parking tickets, Haven't seen much of you lately, an exact replica of your bite from a fragoloon wild strawberry you left in the fridge. 4. An airplane flew through one ear and out the other. All I could remember was that her stairwell felt right as rain, and the green thumbprint of an unseen hand in an alcove of leaves. Yes, the East River has its many moods, sounding out a panic surface of damp tarp. 5. Shall we take our drinks out on the fucking veranda? It was New Year's Eve at the Odeon, and I was voted best all around with my fake British accent and my vacuous stare. And now, in a hot, bright room in the city, taxis whispering in the snow on the streets below. 6. When sitting next to beautiful people, the most endearing object was always you. Anyway, you never get to know them, not even their Christian names, through the terrible onslaught of breakfast, brunches, and phone calls. All that schlepping and shoving because you don't want anything extraneous in your way. But that's just me. Some like the gorging. 7. So nothing is happening to me while they fly away beyond a white wall. Can you keep up? It'll take weeks to fill you in on the savory details. Me, I'm doing okay up here in my crumbling crow's nest. Land ho, I guess. A newly minted land called Israel, not part of any one person. Its boulevards go quickly by, flanked by houses not built and lived in, that I think Flagstone is set for you to walk on or between. 8. A joyful evening on a sad occasion is better than the reverse, I suppose. Nights after my father's death, I carried my briefcase up and down the stairs to a carol. Dorm life was sublime with its moon-shaped elevator dials. 8.5. Footnotes come to mind in a subsequent march in a continuous succession of goose steps. Then, after a month-long hiatus, I resumed donating blood to the Red Cross. Research made everything take longer, even writing a parade of authors, a lonely vocation. Yet the visible world disappeared, that word spit or spirit enters my mind like a distant steamboat, the fan's steady whir of where, lulls, skulls come back from beyond into beyond, the darkness of a plum high in a plum tree. Is that about?